Okay, let's get back over to Chief Meteorologist Mark Nelson now.
Okay.
Pretty nice weather all around today. Now, you go east of the Cascades, it was just plain hot, as we saw with the fire over there, temperatures in the 90s. But up in the Cascades, look at that, 76 at Ski Bowl. Very nice. Should be good. Good weekend, I think, coming up there. Saturday especially looks nice in the mountains. Now, very calm here in the city right now. Temperatures are in the upper 80s. Tomorrow we're going to be down, I'd say, 10, 12, 15 degrees. So it'll be noticeably cooler tomorrow. Not cool, but just pleasant tomorrow. And Newport, so much sunshine the last couple of days. But temperatures hanging right around 60 degrees. You see a boat headed out. And, oh, look at that, right on the beach, some folks enjoying the water. 68 degrees. Now, that's the air temperature. Remember, the water temperature is never ever warm here on the coast. Actually, I do remember once in the El Nino year of 1997, the water temperatures got up to 70. But that happens like once every 20 years or so. But anyway, the water temperature is right now between 50 and 55 degrees out there. And you see the official numbers today. Salem hit 90, Eugene just under 90. It's possible we go up to 90 here in Portland. We'll probably hit 89 since that's the current temp as well. And then, of course, the hot stuff I mentioned east of the Cascades, Redmond, 94 degrees. But everybody cools tomorrow. So mainly clear tonight. Temperatures down in the 50s, which means if you don't have air conditioning, open the windows by 9 and your house or your apartment will cool off nicely. It'll take a while, but it will get there. So what's ahead? Big picture, when we look at the weather maps that come in, I was going to say I look at them like this, but that's the old days. But nowadays it's on computer, of course. But mainly dry and comfortable. I don't see any significant weather systems. I don't see any heat waves. I don't see any pouring rain. Just comfortable weather, probably through the 4th of July. That's my gut feeling right now from what I'm seeing. I don't see any heat waves in the next 7 to 10 days, which would take us through that 4th of July and maybe the weekend following. We'll see. That's ways out. But low to mid-80s, the warmest days between now and the 4th. Shower chances, I think there will be maybe just a few tomorrow evening and on Thursday, but I don't see any soaking rain the next 7 days or beyond. There may be some showers on Sunday as well, maybe. It's really weak stuff coming in. Now, you can see how the cloud cover by 3 a.m., it's moving inland pretty quickly. So at that time, we wake up, it's pretty cloudy, and by tomorrow, midday, see there's a green spot or two. That's our big chance for a shower. But it's still a lot of cloud cover west of the Cascades tomorrow, mainly sunny east side. Then tomorrow evening into tomorrow night, you do see an area of showers move across. So I think we'll wake up on Thursday morning. There'll probably be some scattered showers around. And then by Thursday afternoon, it's pretty much dry. Friday, look at that. Friday looks great. I think Friday may be mostly sunny. Total rain out of that, you don't see that much coming up. I mean, at most, a tenth of an inch of rain somewhere here in the western valleys. But I think most of us get just enough to wet the streets a bit. So tomorrow in Portland, a lot grayer, but not like gloomy gray. It'll come and go. And there'll be some sun breaks. 68 at noon, nice lunchtime for nice weather for lunchtime outside. And then I think we'll go for a high temperature of 76. Notice the wind switches too from the southwest. A little more humidity in the air because of that. A few light showers on Thursday. Friday looks great. Friday is the warmest day of the next three. And then beyond that, Saturday looks just like Friday, except a little cloudier. But temperature's still around 80. We back it off into the 70s Sunday and Monday. And Tuesday looks dry, and probably Monday should be dry as well. But this is pretty darn pleasant and about as normal as it gets for temperatures for the last few days of June and the first couple of days of July.